Hello Librans, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is a reading for you and your person. So on one side will be your energies, on the other side will be the energies of the person you are dealing with, and then the most likely outcome. And yes, please feel free to swap the characters according to your situation. So let's see what's going on between you and your person. What are the messages? So let's see what are your energy, what's there for Librans. So on your side we have the Ten of Pentacles, okay. What's there on your person's side? The Tower, okay. The most likely outcome, the Four of Wands has flunked up with the Nine of Swords, and the Ace of Wands also wants to come out, okay. So as far as these three cards, I should say, these cards are concerned, we have the King of Pentacles on your side. So Librans, you are quite much in control. Maybe it is just your nature that you are very controlling, but yes, you are in a position of power. That's what I feel. You are in a position of power, self-control, feeling abundant, maybe actually abundant. So you are basically, what I feel is that you are very financially stable, career-wise stable, and at some superior position, maybe a leader, something like that. So this status wise, I should say. So this is your energy. As far as your person is concerned, there has been something on this person's side which has caused some sort of a shakeup, or some sort of something, some beliefs have been shattered over here. Something has happened unexpectedly to this person. This person wasn't expecting something or some sort of a behavior or something from your side, that's what I feel, and which has really shaken them up from the inside. Something unexpected has struck from you, something has happened from your side, some gesture, some word, something which has really shaken. They were not expecting, and they are really sort of shattered, I should say. This is their energy. As far as the most likely outcome is concerned, with the Four of Wands, and behind that was the Nine of Swords, and then the Ace of Wands. So what I feel here is, there is a lot of stress and anxiety going on some one of your sides, or maybe on both sides. So a lot of anxiety, sleepless nights, tension, something is going on, perhaps on the side of the person who is being affected by the Tower, or we'll see in the clarifiers, maybe even the person who has done or said something is also having those sleepless nights or regrets. But yes, then we have the Four of Wands with the Ace of Wands. So definitely there is a new beginning which can be expected in this relation. And with the Four of Wands, it seems to be stable and committed and long-term. So let's have the clarifiers. What is this King of Pentacles about? Why is this King of Pentacles here? What is this King of Pentacles about? Tell me something about this King of Pentacles. So for the King of Pentacles, we have the Ace of Wands, the Death and Rebirth, and the Judgment. Let's have one more. The Nine of Wands. Yes, the Nine of Swords has come on this side also. Just see. One more, the Empress. Okay. Let's see, what is this Tower about? What is this Tower energy about on this person's side? So for the Tower, we have the Two of Pentacles. The King of Pentacles has come up on this side, and now the Justice and the Ace of Pentacles, the Nine of Cups, okay. This was Three of Cups, which is talking about reunions. So let's see, what is this most likely outcome here? What are the clarifiers for this overall energy over here? Anything else about this most likely outcome? We have the Queen of Pentacles, the Knight of Swords, the Eight of Wands, the Seven of Cups, Queen of Swords, and the Magician with the Ten of Cups. Okay. So Tower had come up, the King of Cups, okay. So what I feel here, Librans, is that There was a new beginning. Perhaps this connection started beautifully with a lot of passion and all, but then something has happened in this relationship which has led to the end or a disconnect in this relationship. But the thing is, something else is coming up, and it is going to renew, because following it we have the judgment card. Okay, with the judgment, the nine of swords and the empress. So since with the death and rebirth and the judgment, it seems to be a reawakening of this connection, something which you really are wishing for. You are wishing for the rebirth of this connection. That's what I'm getting. So there was this connection started off beautifully, but then something has happened to this connection that it has ended, or it has come to a pause. Actually, there's a disconnect. It has ended, but then with the judgment, I feel that this side person, whosoever it is, it can be the mix of energies though, just take it as it resonates. So somebody here is definitely wishing for a new beginning in this connection, or a revival of this connection, or I should say, or the rebirth of this connection. And with the nine of wands and the nine of swords, so something, this is happening since a long time, okay? This is happening since a long time, which is, and this waiting for this rebirth of this connection, or waiting for, I should say, this major decision as to when this will come to life again, sort of, is happening since a long time. This wish that may this reconnect happen once more, maybe this person comes back to me. This is a thing which is happening since a long time. And this wait is causing a lot of anxiety to this person. Okay, and then we have the Empress. So what I feel is that with the judgment, the death and rebirth card being there, so it is the waiting and the wishing to get back together which is causing a lot of anxiety, because perhaps a lot of time has passed since this connection has ended. But then we have the Empress, because somebody here is really wishing for the new beginnings. So what I feel is, though, so it started beautifully, but something caused it to end. But then somebody here is really wishing since a long time, and this person is having a hard time coping up with the end. So they are just wishing and praying as to when it will be revived. And here we have the Empress, which is talking about the new beginning. So I think this is the person, this is what this person actually is wishing for, and this is getting manifested over here. Okay, with the Empress, there is a new beginning coming in. For the Tower on your person's side, we have the Two of Pentacles, the King of Pentacles, the Justice, the Ace of Pentacles, the Nine of Cups, and the Three of Cups. So what I feel here is that there was some sort of indecisiveness going on, and that was, and because of that indecisiveness, something happened between both of you, because somebody was not able to make a decision. They were not able to make up the mind. And perhaps because of this decision, this relationship has come to a pause or disconnect because of this indecisiveness. That's what I feel. Okay, and with the King of Pentacles, the Justice, Ace of Pentacles, Nine of Cups. So what I feel here is that perhaps now this is your person which is showing up as the King of Pentacles. You are also the King of Pentacles over here, but now this person is also, maybe after this Tower energy, and whosoever was being indecisive have also now perhaps understood the importance of this connection, perhaps. Well, that's what I feel, is showing up as the King of Pentacles now. And with the Justice and the Ace of Pentacles, the Nine of Cups, what I feel is things are getting sorted out, things are getting balanced, the indecisiveness which was there is coming to a decision now. So now this person is able to decide, basically. That's what I'm trying to say. So the whatever was the cause of indecision, whatever was there which was not being able to decide, they were being so conflicted, now this person is able to stabilize it and give it some conclusion or the decision. And that decision seems to me, with the Ace of Pentacles, a new beginning which is concrete, which is stable, which is long term. So this person is wanting a new beginning now. So the indecisiveness ends and there is a new beginning. So decision is being taken, so indecisiveness is ending, or things are getting balanced and sorted out, and the decision is being taken now for the new beginning over here, which is giving a lot of wish fulfillment and happiness. And with the Three of Cups, there is definitely a reunion which can be expected, or this is what this person wants. As the most likely outcome for this, we have the Queen of Pentacles, the Knight of Swords, the Eight of Wands, the Seven of Cups, Queen of Swords, the Magician, and the Ten of Cups. So now with the Queen of Pentacles and the King of Pentacles, so it is coming up as the similar energy. Both of you are at the same power now. Both of you are feeling very controlled, both control in the sense both of you are feeling very stable, rather I should say. So both of you are in at the same page now. With the Knight of Swords, what I feel is somebody here really wants to rush in towards you with a lot of communication, you or them. Okay, so whatever the confusion was, here we have the Queen of Swords also. So what I feel here is that now this person is perhaps confused. They want to communicate, they want to hurry up towards you, and they really want to communicate, whosoever wants to communicate here. But the thing is, since the other person is very detached and they are really not investing, the other person is detached and not investing, so I think both of you are not communicating each other. So this person is just thinking as to how should I communicate, how should I tell the other person as to I really want a new beginning now, I really want a commitment, I really want this wish fulfillment, I want stability and love. So the thing is, the confusion is about as to how should this be communicated to the other person, whosoever has to communicate here in this relationship, as to this person really, really wants to communicate. But the thing is, perhaps with this death card, things were in such a shape that you really are not talking to each other perhaps. And now the difficulty is how to get through this ice, who is supposed to break the ice and how to break the ice and how to communicate that now this person is ready to come in. Now this person wants a new beginning with you. Let's see what is the message from the universe or the guidance from the universe. Be supportive. Make a genuine effort to show you care. Number 45 may be of some significance for you. So maybe this is the guidance which is coming up. You have to be genuine. Just show genuinely that you really care for the other person so that the other person can trust you and is ready to understand that, okay, this time you are, I should say, authentic in whatever you have to say. So Librans, I just hope it helps and hope this helps. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Let's meet in the next video. Bye.